I made the mistake of following the directions or recommendations for the silicone when I made the original molds, and I did not degas or pressure cast the mold. This is the result of making castings using the original molds. This is a gravity casting. This is a pressure casting. The surface of the silicone mold had thousands of little tiny bubbles on it. It doesn't show up when you're doing the gravity cast, but then you do have a tendency to pick up bubbles on points like the tip of the bow and in places in the hair. When I did the pressure cast, I didn't have any bubbles on the tip of the bow or in the hair, but I had thousands of these little spikes that are sticking out, which is the result of the resin going into all those little bubbles. The quality of the casting is good, other than having all these bumps on it. The surface of the face is good in both cases. You can see all these little spikes sticking out from the pressure casting, and that's just not acceptable. That would take way too long to clean that up. And on the gravity casting, I have a little bubble on the tip of the nose. There's one in the eyebrow, one in the eye, and then a large one and a couple in the neck. And none of those are on the pressure casting. So it's quite apparent I need to remake the molds, degas the silicone and pressure cast the mold, and then pressure cast the resin to get a good quality casting. In fact, the original molds have already been thrown away. And while it's difficult to show all the spikes sticking out on the figures itself, it's very obvious in the casting sprues, and these were off of the body when I did a pressure cast.